Good afternoon and welcome to Chase Office Field in Langley. I'm your match commentator, Katie Hamilton. Today's matchup features two of the top four teams in League 1BC as the Vancouver Whitecaps take on Unity FC. The Caps have had the historic matchup over Langley-based Unity, winning all three of the prior matchups. It'll be crucial for both sides as we head towards the final 2 weeks of the regular season. Before we get to the lineups, let's hear from the coaches.
Okay, well, I'm here with Unity FC's coach, Mike Sharon. Sharon, obviously last time out, 1-0 loss, very close game. However, anything, any little tweaks that you'd like to do to maybe reverse that scoreline?
I'd like to score a goal. we had a few chances we could have taken, and we didn't take them. And obviously then, you know, they took their free kick, and it was well done. And anytime you play against some of the best players in Western BC, it's going to be a tough game. So we need to take our chances today and make sure that we eliminate theirs.
And obviously not too many games left in this season so far. Anything that you guys are looking to work on and end strong with here in the season?
I think we've been good from box to box, and we've had some moments when we're inside our own box that we've let ourselves down, and then we've let ourselves down a few times in the scoring area, right? So I think that's really what we need to sort out. And we have a different squad again today. We've been rotating the squad quite a bit throughout the year, and so we'll see which group shows up and if they're ready to go today.
And obviously you talked a little bit about how you guys have been rotating the squad in and out. So I was just wondering, any changes that you'd like to highlight going into this squad that are going to come up?
Yeah, I mean, we've got a couple young guys playing today. So Jay Sweep's getting his first start today, a 12th grader. So we're excited about him and see what he can do today. And then, you know, it's always the midfield group is always a pretty good group. And then we've got the UBC trifecta of Mihai and Vic and Fuss, right? So those are three quality players. And hopefully they'll be playing a little bit closer to each other today. So hopefully they'll be able to take advantage of some situations today.
Awesome. Thank you. That's everything. And good luck today.
Yeah, thank you.
Awesome. Well, we're here with Vancouver Whitecaps coach Rich Fagan. Fagan, obviously last time out, 1-0 the scoreline. Anything that you remember in particular, that such a close game, anything that you guys can do to maybe make that scoreline a little bit nicer?
You know what? They're a really organized team. They're well prepared. They set up and they're difficult to beat. We need to move the ball quickly. We need to try and get in behind as often as possible, and we need to take our chances. That's the difference.
And obviously all games matter. I know that there's only one game left after this one, but you guys have already clinched. But I was just wondering, anything that you guys would like to do in this last couple games here that makes sure you're ready for this playoff run?
The most important thing for us is performance. If we have good performances, both with and without the ball, we usually win games. So we just want to make sure that we finish the season, this game and the next, with two good performances going into the playoffs.
Awesome. Thank you. And good luck, coach.
Thank you very much.
Good afternoon and welcome to Chase Office Field in Langley. I'm your match commentator, Katie Hamilton. The game is just underway. It's the final League 1 BC featured match of the regular season as the Vancouver Whitecaps U19s travel out to the Valley to take on Unity FC in the home side's final game of the regular season. Playoff positioning is at a premium, and it promises to be a tasty matchup. It's Unity and Whitecaps from Chase Office Field in Langley, our League 1 BC featured match. Whitecaps wearing the navy blue kit going from left to right on your screens. Unity wearing the all-white kit going from right to left. Cleared away for a Whitecaps throw. Your referees for today, Denzel Sharma, Urey Demetris, Liam Abreu, and Stephen Leprechthusen. They'll be calling the match for us here today. Here come the Whitecaps through. Unity. Whitecaps clear away, out for a Unity throw. And your head coaches for today, Mike Sheeran for Unity and Rich Fagan for Whitecaps. We spoke to them earlier about this matchup coming up. The last time they played was a 1-0 win for Whitecaps back on June 14th. The Whitecaps have won all three meetings throughout this BC League 1 league. dating back to last season. So we'll see how this game goes about today. The women's team played earlier, just wrapping up. Whitecaps coming with a 5-4 win late in overtime play. Ball blown down as it was hit by the ref. Ref's going to do a drop ball. Here come Whitecaps. Unity able to step in front. Unity maintaining possession. Back to Silwamba out wide. Long ball over the top. Whitecaps.
Offside, offside.
Capilla stepped in for that one. Referee calls that one offside. Unity will have the ball. Let's take a look at our starting 11 for today. Unity FC with Yeshua Silwamba in nets, number 33. Captain for today, Victory Shambusho. Number 9 will lead his team. Good showing. It'll be a very interesting match between these two teams. Both teams looking for those big 3 points heading into the playoffs. Unity led by head coach Mike Sheeran. Nice ball over the top. Here come the Whitecaps. Luke Norman on the ball. Goes for a cross, deflected out for a Whitecaps corner kick. Here's the Whitecaps with their corner kick. Ball in. Hard ball. Back post. Gets a foot on it. Unity tries to clear it out. Whitecaps pick it up. Unity putting on a bit of pressure. Trying to regain the ball. Whitecaps doing well at keeping possession. Staying calm. Moving the ball around the defensive end nicely. Jaden Mineta sends over top. Flicked on by Chesko. Silwamba. Able to pick that one up. Plays out wide to his right fullback. Silwamba. Whitecaps doing well as dropping into those gaps, making it hard for Unity to find spaces to play up. Unity having a hard time, either setting themselves up so they don't give the ball away or just unable to find lanes to feed it through. Here's one. Picked up by Norman. Here's Luke Norman. Slips. Unity. Victory plays it out wide. Powell taking space. Rossi. CJ Rossi to the line looking for that cross. Blocked by Whitecaps. Out for a Unity throw. Corner kick. Taking a look at the Whitecaps starting lineup. Head coach Rich Fagan has put together a good team looking to get some more points out of this away road trip game. Brennan Fruis will wear the captain's armband for today. Unity corner kick comes in, headed away by Whitecaps. Picked up by Powell. Powell, far post cross, quick touch. Bouncing around through, unable to get a shot. Referee saying handball, giving the kick to Unity. Good chance there for Whitecaps. Lots of popcorn soccer going on. Unable to put it in the back of the net. And here comes Whitecaps on the counter. Good ball through. On his own. Sliding tackle. Grabs the ball. Referee says no play on. Whitecaps call for a handball. This is Captain Brennan Frust. Plays it out wide. Capilla. Down for Norman. Norman being chased. Jovan Mann. Unity just sitting. Letting Whitecaps move the ball around the back end. Don't seem too fazed. Long ball over the top, trying to send his player through. Good ball in. Taken nicely. Here come the Whitecaps. Going for the cross, blocked. And Silwamba comes out. Referee says ball went out, and it's a Whitecaps corner kick. The Whitecaps, 13th game of the season. They've been unbeaten in their last six matches. They have the third most goals for with 17. Almost trying to get one in there. And they have the third least goals against with 11. Here they come again with another corner kick. Jaden Mineta will take this. Good ball. Near post. Cleared away easily by Unity. Foot race here. Sydney Wathula able to get that one first. Plays it back. Whitecaps take their time. Wathuda. Nicholas White takes some space. Capilla. To Frust. Trying to find some space to move forward. Unity is not pressing, deciding to hold back a bit. Nice little flick on. Here comes Unity, picks up the possession. Jordan Lowe plays it up. Referee indicates a foul. Jordan Rossi wins that one. Foul against the Whitecaps. Here's Francis Powell. Takes it quick and short. Back to a center D. Has two on him. Troubling ball. Deals with it well. Unity clears it up the field. Here comes Unity. Just out of touch, able to regain possession. Decides to keep it in. Nick Fussell Has Decky DeFossil. So Wamba wants to put that one high. Referee saying there was a touch off the Whitecaps defender. It'll be a Unity throw. Whitecaps are 5 points behind the first place and second place teams, TSS Rovers and Highlanders FC. They'll want this big 3 points here today. Powell throws in. Receives the ball back. Here comes Powell taking space. Good give and go play. Weeb will want that one back. A little bit too hard on the extra delivery to send his player down the line. Camera's fine. Ball over the top through. Just out of reach of Whitecaps to run onto it. Keepers able to take his time. Slows it down a bit. Beautiful day out here in Langley, BC, around 30 degrees, maybe a little hotter on the pitch. A nice grass pitch, so don't have the issue with the heat from the turf. Fans in the stands have been awesome, and here we go, Unity taking their space. Poked away by Whitecaps. They regain possession. Velios plays that wide. Here's Luke Norman. Good ball over the top, unable to stick. Looks like the wind took it a little bit. There is a bit of a breeze, nothing drastic. Nothing to really change the environment of the game, but there is a slight wind. Whitecaps comfortable with just moving the ball around nicely. Now they're trying to go move a little bit forward. We've seen this so far throughout the first opening 16 minutes. Comfortable playing around the horn on their D line. Now we see Unity starting to press a bit. Try to regain that possession. Good quick ball movement. Referee says Whitecaps throw. Norman plays back. Here's Brennan Frust with some trickery, gets around his player. Plays back again. Looking for those seams, here's Frust. Unity just letting Whitecaps move the ball around, trying to jump on them if they make a mistake like this. Well done by Unity to win this ball back. Gives it away quickly, though. Whitecaps regain possession. Cross ball in by Norman. Taken down nicely. Here come the Whitecaps. Making their run into the box. Cross coming in. Blocked by Unity. Out for a Whitecaps kick. Not too much danger starting in these opening 20 minutes of the game. A little bit slower pace. Quite quiet here on the field. Both planning their attacks. Corner kick comes in. Short one played. Ball back to. Referee indicates an offside. Assistant ref had their flag up. Whitecaps are currently sitting third in the standings with 21 points. 5 wins, 6 draws, and 1 loss. Unity FC sitting one spot behind them in fourth with 17 points, 4, 5, and 4. This is the final regular season game for Unity, so even with a win today, they won't be able to pass the Whitecaps in points. But getting those 3 points for going into the playoffs would definitely be something that they want to go with. Finish off your end of your season strong with a win. Ball goes through. Oh, just out of the reach. Just out of reach of Nick Fussell, trying to keep that one in. He had some space if he could have got a toe on it. Had some space down the line. Throw in, nice good touch. Whitecaps have been moving the ball quite nicely here in the first half. Long ball down the side, setting his player. And he keeps going. Running into bodies, cleared away by Unity. Whitecaps back into play. Velios, 1v1, to Frust. Quick touch in, runs into some bodies. Foul on the play against Velios. Headed on nicely by Weeb. Whitecaps still pick it up. Here's Velios. DeFroost back. Long ball over the top, looking for his four to run onto. A little bit out of way. Zawamba able to pick that one up. Whitecaps moving the ball around, wanting to keep that possession. Ball gets played through. Here come the Whitecaps. Rainbow. Unity picks it up, takes some space. looking for some players to work on too. Ball gets played up. Here's a victory, Shambusho. Driving to net, keeps possession. Lays it top of the box. Unity looking for a shot. Quick shot away, gets blocked. Cleared away by Whitecaps. Unity steps in. Referee's going to call that one foul against Whitecaps. Good opportunity there for Unity, starting with their captain, Victory Shambusho. He's a former Varsity FC player. 75 games played. He's got 43 goals, 7 assists in 5 years at UBC. And he scored in the final with TSS Rovers. He set that one up. We'll see who takes this, if they'll go on for a shot. It's a juicy spot to take a chance at net. Joey Cio stands on top of this. Joey Cio goes for a low shot, blocked. Unity regains, picks up far post cross, blocked again, headed away by Whitecaps. Here comes Whitecaps looking for the corner, long ball down the line. Out of reach for Whitecaps forward to play on too. Unity regains possession. Here comes Unity. Good passing play to get out of their end. Victory doing well to get away from his defender. Has some space is Hajdeki. CJ Rossi through into the middle. Jordan Lowe plays out wide. Here comes Unity. They've done well at having some possession here. Quick shot away. Blows past the left-handed side. So far to start the first half, we saw Whitecaps with quite a bit of the possession. Lots of it moving just behind the D line, moving it back and forth. Not exactly penetrating going forward, but had lots of possession. Good to see Unity doing some as well. Referees indicating a drinks break. Around 30 degrees out here in Langley, maybe a little bit more out on the pitch. It's a hot one, so they'll take their quick couple-minute break to have a drink of water. The League One BC's featured match on TELUS Optic TV is presented by the Hall Group of Companies. Together, we support League One BC, its players, coaches, referees, and community. We're playing here at Trinity Western University. Canadian men's national team and former Rover, former Calvary, and now CF Montreal player Joel Waterman played here with TWU. Last game, the Unity men tied 1-1 with Rivers last Saturday. They have the second most goals for with 24, fourth least goals against with 14. And we said this before, but it's their final game of the season. So a big one. You want to end off your season right, get those 3 points, and get prepared for playoffs. Whitecaps, on the other hand, their last game was a 3-1 win over Harbourside. 13th game of the season for them, unbeaten in their last 6 matches. Third most goals with 17 and third least goals against with 11. They will play next weekend in Kamloops against Rivers. We're going to send it down to our sideline reporter, Liam, with an update.
Thanks, Katie. So just there in the break, I could hear Vancouver's coach, Rich Fagan, just going over that. That might be the best 25 minutes of play that the Whitecaps have played all season. So we'll have to see if they change anything going up into the next half here.
Thanks, Liam. Yes, we did see Whitecaps have quite a bit of possession, moving the ball around nicely, trying to go in for those attacks, strong on the side of down on the field. Playing more quality, moving the ball around the back nicely. I'd like to see them go forward a little bit faster, a little bit more, if they have those areas. But again, you don't want to just play for the reason of playing it through. Referee is changing the ball. Doesn't like the way that one feels. Maybe a little bit too flat. We also got a train passing behind us, so apologies for the loud racket. New ball is in play. Referee likes this one. He says game on. Long ball over the top, trying to send his player. And it drops. Here come Whitecaps. Good ball over to the side. Quick shot, blocked. And goes out for a Whitecaps corner kick. Good chance there for Whitecaps. And yes, we saw that. And we heard from our sideline reporter, hearing that the Whitecaps are happy with how they've played in the first 25, 28 minutes. Keeping possession, moving the ball around nicely. Like I said, I would like to see them go forward a little bit more, but they're utilizing their chances properly, not trying to force anything, looking for those ideal spots to attack from. Here's a corner kick coming in. Right in the middle. Did he get a touch on it? Referee calls for another corner kick from the other side for Whitecaps. That's Unity keeper Silwamba getting a quick touch to keep it out of the net and goes out for a corner kick. Kicks coming in. Short one, cleared away. Quick shot by Whitecaps, and it's in. A beautiful volley shot by the Whitecaps. Referee's whistle actually has indicated an offside. Linesman had their flag up. Referee's calling that one offside. No goal. We liked the finish. We like the celebration. But it stays scoreless here. 0-0. Here's Velios with a throw. Quick in. Out again for a Whitecaps throw. We have our sideline reporter Liam, who has an update for us.
Thank you, Katie. You got on the sideline there after that little miss. Vancouver Whitecaps head coach not too happy with the call, offside being the call, why that goal was disallowed here. We'll have to see moving forward. A lot of complaints so far I'm hearing about the officiating going on so far. Thanks, Katie.
Thanks, Liam. Yes, it's hard without VAR to see if that was offside. We'd like to see it again. But a good chance for Whitecaps, a great finish. Here comes Whitecaps again, a nice little through ball. Unity picks it up. Cleared away, sending Weeb. Here's CJ Rossi. Running out of space on the sideline. Good chance there. We've seen he's had speed and has good technical foot abilities. That'll be an interesting matchup to watch for the remainder of the season, or this match. Referee calls that one down against Victory. Free kick for Whitecaps. Taking a look here at that offside goal. Ball comes in. Shot is taken. Just getting interfered in the way of the goalkeeper. Maybe that's what the referee is calling here. Here come Whitecaps with some space and some speed. Plays out wide. Back to the top. Quick shot away right to the hands of the keeper. Good chance for the Whitecaps. Probably would have liked to connect a little bit different, find a different space, not right to his hands, but nonetheless, a good opportunity there for them. Here comes Unity. Goes for the cross. Alexander. Easy snag for him. Still scoreless here, 34 minutes into this League 1 BC's featured match, Whitecaps versus Unity Football Club. Both teams have exchanged some chances. One goal getting disallowed by Whitecaps on an offside call. Long ball over the top. Velios takes that one nicely. Velios. Little shove from behind. Ref says keep playing. Little flick over top. Little trickery. No one else was on it, though. You can see that Whitecaps are eager and hungry to get on the score sheet here. Hajdeki takes his time till Dorman comes to press. Hard tackle in, Whitecaps. Frust. Back for Capilla. Capilla through the middle. Good switch ball out wide. Both teams just happy with chilling at the moment, trying to fill the spaces, not let either team penetrate through. Frist trying to feed his forward. Unity picks it up. Well done by Francis Powell to get that out. Referee plays advantage, and here comes Unity. Ball fed through. Here's Rossi with the shot. Just over the crossbar. Good chance there for Unity. Quick play. Whitecaps are back at it. Joven man. Velios. De Frust. Referees, assistant linesmen's flag goes up, offside, Whitecaps. Victory Sean Bouchot. Strong game so far in this first half. Ball stays on this grass. Hajdecki. Low, back. There's Joey Sio, plays that wide. Back to Silwamba. Silwamba goes for the clear. Flicked on over the top. Whitecaps pick up possession. Referee is going to call that one. Free kick for Whitecaps. Just at half mark. 39th minute of this first half League One BC featured match. Not too many chances, a few for both teams, but nothing wild. One goal disallowed. Both teams comfortable with moving the ball around their back end. Waiting for the right time to attack. Here come Whitecaps. Cleared away by Alexander. Unity gets there first. Joy Sio heads it in. Whitecaps leave it or he would be offside. Alexander picks it up. A little bit quiet. I'd like to see a little bit more pace here. I know both teams are feeling it out, not making any mistakes, trying to keep possession, but a little bit more intensity, a little bit more speed I'd like to see. Make those chances, creativity. Here comes Unity. Takes a shot, well over top of the crossbar. Nick Fossil, who just finished UBC's fourth year. He's a former varsity player, played 67 games, 12 goals, 10 assists. Little kick, yep. Unity able to maintain possession. Here's Sio. Hard tackle in. Ball bounce. Takes a good pounce. Referee lets him play. Norman looking for a call. Play continues. Hajdecki might have got away with one. Here's Sio. Weeb. Good passing. Here comes Unity. Ball out wide to Victory. Defended well by Whitecaps. We have a player down on the pitch. Referee's blown his whistle. Calling in for a trainer to come take a look. It is quite hot out here, around 30 degrees out in Langley. Beautiful day though, blue skies, great fans, a nice grass pitch, a little bit lumpy in few areas, but overall a nice grass pitch. Good time for the players to grab a quick sip of water. The League One BC featured match on Telesoptic TV is presented by the Hall Group of Companies. Together, we support League One BC's three pillars of community, opportunity, and standards. Little impromptu water break here. Get the teams able to have a quick chat, get their game plan going. Whitecaps changing their formation a bit, going from a different tactical route. They've had good possession so far, moving the ball around nicely. Few chances down the side. Same goes for Unity, blasting a few over top of the crossbar. Referee is ready to begin. Unity throw. Capilla rejoins his Whitecaps squad. Hajdecki. Nick Fossil. Taps out. Into touch for Unity. Last few minutes remaining here in the first half. We'll see if someone can put themselves on the scoreboard. Ooh, chance there. Quick shots and a goal. Unity up 1-0 here in the first half of our League 1 BC's featured match. Great goal by Unity. We'll take another look at it here. Unity FC taking the lead late in this first half. And the replay comes in. Quick shot. Little tap. Number 28, Jace Weeb, gets his team up on the board. 1-0 here in League 1 BC. Referee has indicated 4 minutes of added time here in this first half. Around 3 minutes left in this opening half. Whitecaps versus Unity. Jace Weeb putting his team on the board. First goal of the game. Weeb used to play in the Whitecaps Academy, but now with Unity, must be a good goal to get. Feels good to score against an old club that you used to play throughout their system. Hajdecki, long ball over the top, trying to send his forward. Good hustle. Gets there. Brings down his player. Referee calls that one a foul. Whitecaps free kick. Alexander, big boot over the top, right back to his other goalie friend. Go, 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 go. Weeb, little flick on. Cleared away by Whitecaps. Low. Unity on the attack. Good ball out wide, looking for the cross. Cross comes in. Didn't connect like he probably thought he wanted to. Played out of bounds by Whitecaps. Unity into touch. Hajdeki there to play back to his keeper. So Wamba to Low. Sio. Back to Hajdeki. Here's Francis Powell. Long ball over the top by Hajdeki, in for Rossi, out of bounds, unable to keep it in. And there goes the halftime whistle here at Chase Office Field in Langley. 1-0, the home team scoring first, drawing the first blood. They scored late in this first period. Jace Weeb, number 28, putting his team up 1-0. Good match so far. Both teams exchanging chances. Not the most exciting first half, but I think both teams try to have quality, try to keep possession, not give away silly plays like that, which they did well at. We'll see how the Whitecaps turn around through the second half after taking a quick break. See how they do. We'll have our sideline reporter doing a halftime interview soon. Okay, let's send it down to our sideline reporter, Liam, who's standing with Jace Weeb.
Jace, how does it feel to finally get on the board there after one disallowed one? What's it feel like to get into the locker room with a lead?
Oh, man, it's great. We really need this game. And, you know, the boys are coming out with some hunger today, and we want to win. So it takes us to playoffs, so it's a big goal. But we got to continue to work really hard in the second half.
Awesome. And I talked to Mike before the game, your coach, obviously, and he said one of the main things between the differential, obviously, last time was a 1-0 loss here against Vancouver. He said he really wanted to see you guys get on the board. And what do you think some of the things that you are going to have to do today to keep getting on the board?
Yeah, it's going to be a gritty game. I mean, it's really hot outside, so we just got to stay compact as a team. We have to go with the game plan and, you know, just staying compact as a unit, force them to try to play centrally. And let's just see if we can utilize, you know, hard runs in the box more and try to score some more goals.
Thanks, and good luck next half, buddy.
One BC was built to provide opportunity for everyone involved with the game in our province. The Hall Group proudly supports its own workforce while offering training and opportunity for new recruits to its multiple divisions. A partnership that provides people with the tools they need, both on the field of play and in the field. Hall, together we rise as one.
Like, am I doing enough? Am I gonna achieve anything? Like, I didn't see anybody like me. So it was obviously really tough. It's just like, am I there for nothing? Am I doing this all for nothing? Like, there's nobody, I had nobody to like look up to.
And me, after I finished a game, I'd just look into the stands and sometimes I'd have family, sometimes I wouldn't. And then it'd be like kind of like a little, you sit in the change room, you give yourself like a little self vibe.
Programs haven't been accessible, nor have they been created that are culturally safe for Indigenous children and youth. So we wanted to close that gap.
Natsumat FC is owned by Hope and Health and aims to get young Indigenous athletes into a higher level of sport.
Hope and Health is a sport for social impact organization that works specifically with Indigenous children and youth and their communities. We really have been working on creating the pathway from those young, talented athletes that aspire to go pro or play to an elite level as high as they can go. It's about creating program that's accessible within Indigenous communities.
Sometimes all you just need is that one, or even that one person that believes in you. And I'm hoping this platform of Natsuma, and even me just being here, will show other Indigenous youth and other players that you can do it. You just, dedication, hard work, and lots of just faith, and just reaching out to, like putting yourself out there and not being afraid of like the racial barriers or like people doubting you that you can't do it.
It created an identity for us. With varsity, it was about UBC athletes preparing for the fall season for Canada West, and when Natsuma came in, there was a bigger picture, a bigger focus, and we're living it every day with our identity, with trying to increase the Indigenous pathway and open up a big door for players to come through.
You know, it's not just the players too. Like, I've got an assistant coach. There's some game op stuff, so it does go beyond the players.
Oh, yes. The finish. All right.
For Natsumat FC players, it's important for them to give back and mentor the next generation.
I think it's a win-win for everyone, for our UBC athletes to get into communities that may not even be thinking about university, and they get to see student athletes firsthand. I think that's a positive to show that there's a pathway not only for sport but into post-secondary as well.
When they think of soccer, they don't think of us, and obviously that's very hard because growing up, that was my FIFA. Going to tournaments, watching it was my FIFA. Like, that was my World Cups. Watching them play, it was like other players I couldn't see in TV.
As an Indigenous youth, like, we're representing our community, not just ourselves. Like, it takes a village to raise a child. Like, for me as an example, I had uncles, aunties, coaches, a plethora of people that like helped support me. And it really shows like growth and development. And you're just there to represent your people to the best of your abilities and just make whoever proud and yourself proud, more importantly, and then just walk in a good way.
Natsumat FC is in their first season of competition with 11 Indigenous athletes across the men's and women's teams, as well as several Indigenous coaches and members of the backroom staff.
Like, that's it. This is a big moment just to like prove Indigenous players have capabilities and opportunities to show talent, because there's a lot that fall through the cracks that just don't get that opportunity.
I already know what this is going to bring, and I'm so excited. Like, I can't even express the emotions.
League 1 BC is a critical new level of play that supports soccer's infrastructure in the province. The Hall Group was built on infrastructure projects in British Columbia. This premier partnership between two built-in BC groups promotes the highest standards for people and their growth, while building communities in our province, both on the field and in the field. Hull, together we rise as one.
Okay, everybody, let's have a great show. Look out, Karen Masson, got it.
There to Jesse King, who scores again!
At West Shore Motorsports Park.
Canada's always had participation on the women's side, participation on the men's side, but at some point you have to turn that into a pathway.
The amount of times I get emails or phone calls from young soccer players asking, how do I make it? How do I do this? There's so many different pathways that players can take. 90% of those pathways are to leave our country, and that's what we have to change.
Canada soccer is a very interesting setup when you think of top soccer countries. You're not usually thinking of Canada.
Everybody looked at it and said, we need a league.
We'll be right back.
Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Chase Office Field in Langley. I'm your match commentator, Katie Hamilton. We are coming back from the first half where Jace Weeb of Unity scored in the final minutes of the first half to give Unity a 1-0 lead coming into the second. It was a good first match. We saw a few chances exchanged by Unity and the Whitecaps. Not too much excitement and entertainment as far as shots, but there's still plenty of time, and I think now that Whitecaps are down one goal, we'll see more chances being made this second half. So the Caps have had a historic matchup over the Langley-based Unity. They've won all three prior matches, so we'll see if this changes as Unity's up 1-0. Before we get to that, here is the second half. Whitecaps starting off the second half with possession. They did well in the first half, moving the ball around nicely, especially on their D line. Both teams kind of held back in that first half, not pressing too hard, letting the other team play the ball around their defense, around the horn, and really clogging up those seams. So we'll see if that's the game plan here today again for the second half. Again, Whitecaps down a goal. I'd like to see them be a little bit more aggressive on the attack, going for those chances, for those shots. They have some very fast, speedy, and tactical players, so we'll see that here in the next few moments. Whitecaps throw. If you're just tuning in, the Whitecaps are wearing the navy kit going from right to left on your screen. And Unity in the all-white kit going from left to right on your screen. Sun has just gone down, so not too much of a factor for the keepers with having sun in their eyes. Beautiful day, still around 30 degrees, maybe a little bit under. Hot one here at Chase Office Field in Langley. Devin Chesko heads that one through. Here's CO. Chesko. Silwamba. Tough ball. Whitecaps take that one quickly. Hennessy feeds that one through for his player. Here comes the Whitecaps. Referee had his offside flag up. Good to see Whitecaps on the attack early in the second half. Just getting started underway. Captain Victory taking the ball down nicely. Here come Unity. Ball gets played through. Will it stick? Weeb runs onto it, saves it. Goal scorer, Weeb, plays it back. Here's CO. Fussell plays it through. CO with a cross. That was Mihai Hodut on the chance there. He'll take the corner kick. Cross coming in. Low cross cleared away by Whitecaps easily. Back in by Chesko. Easy for Alexander to grab. And quick throw. Sending Norman. Norman was active in the first half, having a few chances. Using his right-hand side and using his speed. Mineta. Good move. Given to Unity, throw in. Here's Hoda with the throw. Good challenge there. Good one touch. Here's Victory slowing it down. Good ball movement here by Unity. Long throw in, cleared away by Whitecaps. Unity will be into touch. The Caps have had the historical matchup over Langley Base Unity. They've won all three of the prior matchups from last year and this time. The last time these two teams played. Good cross coming in. And a shot! Fires it. Way high and wide. Last time these two teams played was a 1-0 win for Whitecaps back on June 14th. If Unity can hold this lead, this will be the first victory they've had over the Vancouver Whitecaps. Nice ball in. Here comes Whitecaps down. Tipped away by Unity. Unity picks up possession. Sydney Wathuda, nice move, breaking down the side, slips it through to Hennessy. Hennessy with a cross, no one there for Whitecaps. Sawamba able to scoop that one up, nice and easy. Referee is calling that one back. Referee has a talking to with Victory Sambusho. No card is given. Substitution coming in. Number 27, Kieran Eve. Coming in for Unity. Nick Fussell, number 15, coming out. Here's Jaden Mineta. Good ball into the mix. And Silwamba able to jump up and grab that ball out of trouble. Referee calls a handball there. Playoff positioning is at a premium. And this matchup between these two teams is definitely tasty because what happens here also affects the playoff positioning. So both teams will want to come away with the 3 points, secure their spot in the lineup for playoffs. Whitecaps will have another game after this. They'll travel to Kamloops to play the Rivers next weekend. This is Unity's last home game of the regular season, last game of the regular season. So they'll want to finish strong, getting those 3 points in a good win here against the Whitecaps. Here's Hennessy. Lots of space down the line. Feeds through. Nice, good, quick touch. With Uda. Good cross ball. Cross comes in. Back post. Cleared away by Unity. With Uda picks it up. Good footwork. Finds his captain, Fruist. Whitecaps earn themselves a corner kick. Lots of time still here to play in the second half of this matchup. Whitecaps have a lot of time to come back and try to even up the score. Jace Weeb scored for Unity late in the first half. Cross coming in. Low ball cleared away nicely by Unity. Picked up by Whitecaps. Oof. And a quick chance there for Whitecaps, just going off of the top crossbar. Sio out wide for Hodut. Hodut breaking through, does a nice loss across on the ball. Cleared away by Whitecaps. Here's Hennessy. Plays it out wide. He had some space in front of him to take it. Unity picks it up, still in the attacking zone. Here's Jordan Lowe. Chesko over to Hajdeki. Back to Hodut. Here's Lowe. Whitecaps pick it up. I'd like to see a little bit more movement in the box when Unity has the ball like that. They had some space to play, but lots of their forwards were just hanging out in the box rather than kind of finding movement play, finding some open spaces, making those plays to get a shot on net. Good possession here by Unity. Hajdeki plays out wide. Good ball down through, and here comes Unity into the box, looking for that cross. Cross comes in, cleared away by Whitecaps. First picks it up. Whitecaps have some space in numbers. Loses that one. Ref says play on, get up. Unfortunate, that was a good chance for Whitecaps. They had room, they had space, they had players jumping in on the play. Ball kind of got out of his feet there. Whitecaps maintain position. Good ball down, looking for that cross. Cross comes in, all the way through, cleared away by Hodut. Whitecaps into touch. First, plays it in. Good passing play by Whitecaps, and he blows it over top of the crossbar. Good little passing play in from Velios to Captain First. He'll want that shot back, a little bit more on target. Victory out wide. This is CJ Rossi. Furlow. Weep. Little flick on. Another one. Oh, and a big shot off the head and into the goal. That's a goal for Unity. 2-0 here at Chase Office Field. We'll have to see that one again. Unlucky for goalkeeper Ben Alexander. Shot goes blocked, comes back right off of his face into the back of the net. I think he'll take it. A goal is a goal. Unity up 2-0 against the Whitecaps here in the second half of this League One BC's featured match. Whitecaps will have to change something up if they want to get two more goals here. Either tie it up or try to get the victory themselves. Now down 2-0. 30 minutes left of play. Lots of time to get your name on the board. Cleared up the line. Victory runs onto it. Ball played back to the keeper. Pressured. Oof, just snuck by his foot there. Goalkeeper got away with that one.
Substitution for Whitecaps FC in the 60th minute. End of the game, number 98, David Ajabi, replacing number 89, Michael Hennessy.
Here's Whitecaps, good little flick through. Driving towards into the box. Nice little touch around his defender. Feeds it through. Blocked and cleared away by Unity. Good passing play. Someone needed to pull the trigger on there. Shambusho plays it back. Nice little flick by Victory Shambusho. Him and Lowe playing well. Off the chest. We'll send it down to our sideline reporter, Liam, for an update.
Thank you, Katie. I'm here on the sidelines, and I was just overhearing coach of Unity FC, Mike Sharon, telling him how that's exactly how you draw it up, right into the back of the net there off the face. But in all seriousness, they're not trying to let up here. You can hear just in Mike's voice, he wants to keep that pressure up here for Unity and make sure that maybe even get a couple more. They're definitely not going to back off here in these last few minutes.
Thanks, Liam. That's right. Not the most beautiful goal, but you'll take it, right? You don't see that one every day, taking a shot, getting the rebound off your face and going into the back of the net. So I'm sure Coach Sheeran is happy with the way his team is playing right now. Two goals up, and here comes Whitecaps. Cross coming in. Oh, and unable to connect. Ball sits still for Silwamba to be able to pick up. Scoreline stays the same. Silwamba's been very busy today. Few good saves. Going for that clean sheet. Well done by Jordan Lowe to use his body, get the ball back. Here comes Unity, trying to chip the goalie, I think he was going for. Either a chip, because there's no one close to the ball. Not sure. He kind of looks confused, so does the goalie. Referee's blown the whistle. We have a player down. Hodud with a head, holding his head, looks to be back up on his feet. Needed a moment. Seems to be okay. Referee's going to give the free kick to Unity. Whitecaps don't seem pleased with it. Say the ball was out. But referee's going to go with a free kick for Unity here. Good ball over the top. Back to Alexander. Here's Frust. You could hear the keeper yell, pick it up, boys. They want this win. They want the 3 points. Last two games of their regular season for the Whitecaps. Here's Luke Norman. Back to Velios. Here comes Weeb, goal scorer, tries to play it through. Too close to the keeper, picks that one up quick, and here come Whitecaps taking their space. Like to see Whitecaps get a little bit more of an aggressive tack going. Down 2-0 now. Second half, got to put some goals in the back of the net. Cross comes in, and a shot! Just like that, Whitecaps split the lead in half. 2-1 here at Chase Office Field. We'll see the replay here. Ball comes in, nice little cross. Quick touch. Luke Norman getting his foot on it. Substitution coming in for Unity. Number 3, Joel Badger, will be coming on, taking the spot of CJ Rossi. Well, we have a game here. 2-1. Anything can happen. Lots of time left. Just over 23 minutes left to play.
Into the game, number 3, Joel Badger, replacing number 17, CJ Rossi.
Here comes Othuda, lots of space on the left. Plays in the middle. Joven man. Good ball down the side. Here come Whitecaps wanting more. Luke Norman. Driving down to the line, goes for the cross. Intercepted and cleared away by Unity. That's Jaden Mineta to Nicholas White. Velios. First. Cleared away by Unity. Weeb picks that one up. Whitecaps maintaining some of the possession here after scoring that goal. Still plenty of time on the clock for anything to happen.
Whitecaps FC goal scored in the 67th.
Good ball over the top for Norman to run onto. Back to Withuda. Withuda looking for that left-footed cross, back far post. And it soars all the way out for a goal kick. Here comes Whitecaps again. Ball gets played through. Here's Norman. It looks like he's onside. Cross comes in. Hajdecki able to get a foot on it. Clears it out. Whitecaps coming back for more. Out for a unity throw. Luke Norman, goal scorer for Whitecaps, played youth soccer at Fusion FC and played in the FVSL this year. Jagby plays it back. Shot. Oof. Rocket shot right to the hands of Silwamba. Not a bad chance. Has some good power behind it. Looking for that equalizing goal. Headed away by Nicholas White. Weeb picks it up. To Victory. Victory playing it through. Whitecaps able to get a step on him. Have some space. Here comes the captain, Roost. Tries to play it over, but a unity head gets in the way. Grabs his rebound. Good ball through. Here comes Whitecaps. Norman looking for his second. Plays out wide to Wathuda. Cross comes in. Blocked. Referee calls that one. Free kick for Hodut of Unity. Referee also indicates a quick break for a drink of water. It's quite a warm day today in Langley, BC, around 30 degrees. Again, playing on the grass turf kind of helps having that heat, unlike when you play on the turf. The fellas will take a quick break here, grab some water, and regroup. So far, more chances we've seen, a little bit more of an attack from both teams in the second half compared to the first. I'd like to see even just a little bit more energy and intensity. It's quite quiet on the pitch. You hear a few players talking, but overall, not too much. They're moving the ball around nicely, though. Both teams, Whitecaps, you can tell they're confident moving around their back line. Same goes for Unity, but I'd like to see both of them play a little bit more aggressive on the ball, bring it up a notch in these final 20, 15 minutes of the match. We're going to send it over to our sideline reporter with an update.
Thanks, Katie. Down here on the sideline, once again, after a little drinking party, you could hear that the Vancouver Whitecaps getting very, very upset and frustrated with this 2-1 deficit right now. Obviously, we talked a little bit before about how they're undefeated currently against Unity, and right now you can feel the frustration and the desperation for them to try and get back in this one.
Thanks, Liam. Yes, Whitecaps have won all three meetings. Last time they played was a 1-0 win for Whitecaps on June 14th. They sit third and fourth in the standings. Whitecaps 5-6-1 with 21 points sit in third. Unity 4-5-4 with 17 points sit in fourth. Even a win today for Unity, they'll still be behind Whitecaps in the points, as this is Unity's last game of the regular season. Whitecaps, on the other hand, they lose today. They'll still have one more chance to get 3 points. But again, those final positionings for playoffs are not fully confirmed, so a win is wanted for both sides. Underway here after our drinks break. Here comes Unity, good step. Looking for that long shot, bottom post, off the post, comes back in a shot, stays out again. How does that happen? Two great chances, good opportunities. We'll have to see that one again. Whitecaps pick it up. Little push. Ref says play on. Here's Cio. Powell. Out wide for Lowe. Lowe with a cross. Way far post. Badger running onto it. Keeping it in. Ball squeaks through. Referee is calling that one. It had a tip to it, so he's counting it as a corner kick. Substitution coming in for Unity. Number 8, Marcel Bona coming in. And here's the chance. Right-footed shot. Off the post. Bounces back. Another shot. Looks like he got deflected under the keeper and goes out for a corner kick, or the Whitecaps were able to scoop it up. Two awesome chances there for Unity. They'll have another one here off a corner kick. CO coming out for Marcel Bona. Number 8 will be going in.
End of the game, number 8, Marcel Bona replacing number 6, Joey CO.
Cross coming in, far post, headed away from Whitecaps. Badger picks it up. Joel Badger gets away from his defender. Referee says play on. Badger got a little trip there. Here comes Whitecaps. Ran out of space. Into touch for Unity. So Wamba picks that one up. Badger puts on pressure here. Whitecaps looking for that equalizing goal. Ball over the top. Here's Lowe. Blocked. Referee is calling the foul back. No advantage there. It'll be a free kick for Unity. Number 2, Devin Chesko. Chesko joining St. Francis University this fall. Takes the kick. Big kick over the top, looking for Weeb. Headed out by Whitecaps. Victory picks it up. Referee says play on. Whitecaps player down. Looks like he's holding the back of his head. Referee will call it. Looks like he's holding his ear. Possibly on that knock that just happened. That's Captain Brennan Furst, number 82. We have some substitutions coming in for Unity. Number 24, Xander Roxburgh, will be coming in, as well as number 10, Rahid Rahim, Jordan Lowe will come out for a sub. Victory Shambusha will also come off for a sub. Two strong games for those two men that are coming off. There's number 24, Xander Roxburgh.
In the 80th minute, in the game, number 24, Alexander Roxburgh, replacing number 9, Victory Shambusha. Into the game, number 10, Raheed Rahim, replacing number 12, Jordan Lowe.
Here come Whitecaps. Top of the box. Looking for a shot. Here's Norman. Running into a sea of white. Quick shot by Nick White, who has jumped into the matchup. Cross blocked by Unity. Referee is blowing his whistle. Free kick for Whitecaps there. With just under 10 minutes left of this regular play of the game. Whitecaps have moved center D. Nicholas White up
for the sponsorship this season.
Ball comes in. Cleared away by Unity. Mineta takes space. Out wide for Wathuda. Plays in. Here's Norman, goal scorer. Plays it to the other team in Whitecaps. Gave it away. Here comes Unity. Good ball out wide. Rahim. Lots of space on the right-hand side. Good little play through. Referee calls it. Foul. Pointing to the PK sign. We'll have to see that one again. Whitecaps in disbelief. Not impressed with that call. Here it is. Ball gets played through. A shove. I think it was embellished a little bit, but referee calls the PK. Number 22, Francis Powell, taking the shot. And saved! Big save by Ben Alexander to keep the scoreline where it's at. And here come the Whitecaps. Wathuda. On the left-hand side. Good first touch. Chip over the top. Headed away by Unity. Roxburgh. Here's Rainbow. Badger. Sneaks that one away. Cleared away by Unity. Unity's got some numbers. 3v3. Badger looking for the middle. Looking for that crossbar. And here comes Whitecaps. Oof. Saw that one coming. Referee's got his yellow card out. That's a yellow card given to number 27, Kieran Eve. So here's the save on the PK. Low shot. Didn't seem like he got too much power behind it. Easy save for the keeper. Now for the tackle going in.
Yellow card caution.
Yeah, no ball. No ball at all. Yellow card. He knew what he was doing going into it. Crossbar into the middle. So Wamba, all game, has been very good at finding those, making sure he's first two, giving no rebounds. Has been solid back there for Unity. Jace Weeb looking to flip it on. Whitecaps looking to get that equalizing goal. They've switched their formation. Looks like they're playing three in the back. Moved one of their center backs up. Nicholas White now playing up as a forward. Here comes Badger with Unity. Ooh, and a step in. Refs going. Another yellow card given. That's Jaden Madetta receiving the yellow card. Badger up on his feet. Let's see that one. Badger coming in. Just going full body, not going for the ball. Steps into him. Gave Unity a juicy spot for a free kick late here.
Yellow card caution given to Vancouver Whitecaps FC number 73, Jaden Manetta, in the 86th minute.
Looks to go out wide to Badger. Badger crosses it. Creative play. Here come Whitecaps. Norman. Looking for that cross ball. Slices a bit. Referee's calling that one. Not too impressed is Jalen Velios. Whitecaps running out of time if they're wanting to get another one in the back of the net. Referee's giving a yellow card to Captain Brennan Fruce. Must have said something.
Yellow card caution given to Whitecaps FC number 82, Brennan first in the 88th minute.
Unity with the free kick over by the corner. Have Badger and Raheem standing over top of the ball. We'll see what they want to do with it. Plays it short. Kills a little bit of time. Keeps it in the corner. Ball goes out. Unity into touch. Unity throw again. Here's a chance for Whitecaps. They don't have too much time remaining. Last minute of play in this regular time. White back to his D-line. We'll see if they push him up again. Ball over the top, headed away by Unity. Velios. Norman. Back to Velios. Here's White. Manetta. Rainbow. Whitecaps keeping possession, looking for the perfect opportunity to get through the Unity squad. Gross coming in, back far post. Headed on. Wathuda grabs it. Oh, Whitecaps unable to pull the trigger. Alexander way out of his box. Does well and plays that one in. Referee indicating 5 minutes of added time here in this match. Good passing play. Here's Velios cross. Blocked by Silwamba. Play stays in. Long cross, far post, headed on.
The fourth official.
Referee's calling it.
The fourth official has indicated that there will be a minimum of 5 additional minutes. Added
possibly
to the
an offside. 5 minutes for Whitecaps to come back and try to score a goal. If Unity can hold on, this will be the first time that Unity has won a match against the Whitecaps. This is also Unity's final match of the regular season, so a great way for them to finish off their regular 2023 season with a win. But there's still roughly 4 minutes left in this match. Can Whitecaps do it? Can they come back and score one more to tie it up? I'd like to see them be more on the attack. Drive forward, get their bodies and plays up there. Take shots on net. Try to find those bouncing plays. Here's Norman. Duffin gets first ball. Ref says play on. Norman picks up. So Wamba gets hands on that. Joven man, ball over the top. Cross coming in, back of the box. Norman with it just goes. Referee says no tip. He's saying it's a goal kick. Whitecaps not impressed. They go right up to the referees to express their anger. And given a white card is a yellow card is Nicholas White. He's already has one, so he's received a red and will be coming off for these final minutes of the match. With this red card, he will miss next match game in Kamloops. Whitecaps playing down with 10 players. They're the last 2 minutes of this game. Still down a goal. They have challenges set against them. Good touch there. Quick shot. Blasts it over top. Would have liked a little bit more finesse
yellow
on that one.
Yellow card given to Whitecaps FC number 68, Nicholas White, in extra time.
Final few moments of this match. Unity up 2-1. If they can hold on for this last moment, it'll be their first win against the Whitecaps. Velios. Thomas Rainbow playing it through. Just out of way. Unity able to get there first. Here's Badger trying to dive through. Gets a little bit armsy. Referee calls it back. Go into his pocket. Yellow card comes out. Yellow card, I believe, for Dylan Velios. We'll have to confirm. Referee, there's the final whistle of this match. Unity coming away with a big 3 points, winning their final game of the regular season here at Chase Office Field in Langley. Whitecaps did their best. They came back from a 2-0 deficit. Goals scored. Jace Weeb opened up the game, scoring for Unity, followed by Jordan Lowe in the second half, scoring it off of his face. But we'll take it. It's a goal. And then Luke Norman going for the Whitecaps, scoring late in the second half.
Unity FC leads Whitecaps
will probably want that one back. But congrats to Unity for winning their last game of the regular season, as well as beating the Whitecaps for the first time in their club history. Next matches for your men. The Whitecaps play July 23rd. They'll travel to Kamloops for their matchup against Rivers FC. This will be their final match of the regular season. Unity, like I said earlier, today is their last regular season home match. Getting those big 3 points and coming away with a home win is definitely certainly what they were hoping for out of this matchup today. Unity will add 3 points to them, so they'll have 20 points still sitting in fourth, 1 point behind the Whitecaps. They'll stay that way as Unity has had their last match. We'll now send it over to Jake, who's standing by with goal scorer Jordan Lowe.
Okay, I'm here with our goal scorer Jordan Lowe. Bit of a sniper today. So, what went through your head there as you scored that awesome goal earlier?
Not much. I mean, I should have scored the first one, and luckily it came back, bouncing off my face, and we got a goal. So, a goal is a goal, and I'll take it.
Like we said, it goes on your stat sheet regardless. Exactly. But more serious questions now. Obviously, this is your guys' first win against Vancouver Whitecaps FC. So, you know, walk me through how that feels right now.
Oh, it's good. It's an important game for sure. We came in knowing we needed to win, and at the end of the day, we got the result. Feels good.
Yeah, we talked about how this is an important game for you guys. You needed this win to get into that playoff spot there. So, you know, what were some of the things that Coach Mike was going through? What are some of the things you think that you guys executed well?
Oh, he set us well up defensively first half, and then we got the first goal, we got the second goal, and we just held on.
Well, thank you, Jordan. Go have fun with your teammates, and thank you.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
Thanks, everyone. That's it for today. Two big matchups. Our last regular season League 1 BC featured match. We'll be back for playoffs. Thanks so much, and we'll see you later.